To the beach, beach, let's get away. Hey, hey. Again, welcome to the transparency. Sorry for the delay. One more time. Lindsay Partin. Again, excuse the interruption. Guilty, not guilty. What do you guys think? I'm going to tell you guys what I know. Not guilty. Again, guys, welcome to Truth and Transparency. Sunday, I'm going to be doing an explosive live here. It kicks off tonight at 9 p.m. This is a preview to the Lindsay Partin. We're going to close out Lindsay Partin's testimony. But most importantly, we're going to focus in on the questions, or lack thereof, of the defense and prosecution. Lindsay took the stand on the recommendation of her team, and we're really got to focus in on what questions were asked and what questions weren't, and also why would you ever recommend your client to take the stand? And quote unquote, it's never good enough when you hear somebody say, "You got yourself into this mess. You need to get yourself out of this mess." When you hear those words that your defense team would say to you, I think the first thing that anybody would say is nobody got themselves into a mess if you believe that your client is innocent. If somebody was targeted, if somebody was, you know, zeroed in on, if you believe in your client's innocence, then nobody got anybody into anything. So I love discovery. I think that if you truly look at something, and then you can find a lot. But when things can get convoluted, when you're talking about so much coming from so many different areas, and I think that's the case with Lindsay Partin. Your court.
It should be right there, baby.
Where?
Right when you walk in the door, check on the ground over there to the right. So, just like Lindsay, I'm a mom. And I think that it is normal to mom while you want to talk about things, because it's real life, it's everyday life. But I will be closing out the courtroom testimony here tonight at 9. And it just closes out with what Lindsay has said on the stand. It closes out with the remaining part of the defense, or of her team, and then the prosecution on cross-examination, and then the redirect. And before I start that that clip from the court television, I'm actually going to play for me what I just went through. And I had the opportunity to cross-examine a witness or two. And I think that when you are direct with your cross-examination, I've never had one day of law school. But there's a lot of people out there that are making millions and billions of dollars that have never graduated high school, let alone college. I think if you're just good at something, or if you have, you know, common sense that you can kind of, as long as you can, I like to say the word compartmentalize things, that you can cross-examine. And I think that that's where Lindsay's lawyers lost out. I think that they didn't focus enough on what the testimony was of the people that were on the stand. And they were treating them like they were like their own witnesses. So I think if they would have just had focused on what was, you know, the testimony at hand for Lindsay and her, then it would have been a, how do I want to say this? If Lindsay's team would have had their own witnesses, then they would have had them as, you know, this is their direct testimony, right? Lindsay's team used state's witnesses as her own in a weird way. And I'll explain this a little bit more, like I said, because I kind of went through it. And I'm going to use my own personal experience to kind of explain that. Again, I want to thank everybody for being in chat, love. I got, what is it? One of the best soundtracks playing in the background, which is the Stand By Me soundtrack. I believe that that is, you know. So basically, when the night has come, I think the world of Lindsay Partin. And the land is dark. People think I'm nuts though. And the moon is the only light we'll see. But I think that I do have a gift, and I think that I can see through the bullshit. I can see through the, like, there's a forest. Can you see through it? And sometimes you gotta chop down some trees so that you can see through the other side. So, with that said, though, I believe that Lindsay Partin has a opportunity with new evidence to get home to her girls. I think that she deserves to be home and be a mom. It baffles me that people that don't even know the case speak upon it. Lindsay Partin has no criminal background, nothing, nothing. And yet all of a sudden she just starts abusing a child one day, and then within a couple more days, like, come on. Like, doesn't that make people ask themselves like a million questions? Is how could this, okay, if Lindsay Partin is in fact guilty, how did this happen? How did this happen? And I think that's what drove people with the Chris Watts case. On video, he's such a great dad, and then all of a sudden this. Oh, then you find out about this mistress. I'm sorry, but I don't think a piece of pee makes you kill your family. Just saying. But I think that if you were addicted to the Chris Watts case, I think that this case should just be as addictive. Because we're talking about a mom, like Shanann, okay, in a sense. Think about it. A mom, she has her girls, she's just watching kids to help out, make a little side money. More or less, maybe give her kids just like other kids to play with. And then all of a sudden, you're going to say that this woman's a murderer. If this was murder, this was an accident, murder. Come on now. What's Mod Squad saying? Holy crap, too. I won't shed a tear. Just as long as you stand by me. So darling, stand by me. Oh, somebody needs to stand by my new puppy. She needs attention. Oh, I need to hook her up with some of the lesbians in the world. Stand by me. Should crumble to the sea. I won't cry. I won't cry. No, I won't shed a tear. 9 o'clock tonight. 9. You thought it was over. You thought it was over, boy? I wasn't born last night. I know these hoes ain't right. But you was blowing up her phone last night. God, the best soundtrack. How do you not get off on Stand By Me? I think it's the best soundtrack ever made. I think it's amazing. Again, tonight here at 9 o'clock, I'm going to be revealing stuff about Chris. I know everybody should talk about the elephant in the room, which would be Chris. Like, what do people know about Chris? Why would Chris even be spending the night at Jason's house? Who is Chris? And how important is he in actually this case? I will say this right off the gate is the family said that, you know, the only reason that Lindsay didn't want to do a mistrial is because she was hoping to get back to her family. That would have been more time. There is no way that a lawyer would ever advise their client. Like, no, you don't understand. Like, this is a very serious thing. You're looking at X amount of years. You're looking at life. We need this mistrial because we need to find out who Chris Davidson is. Like, I would have withdrawn from Lindsay's representation if she didn't do the mistrial. So there's that. But again, this is going to restart back up at 9. It's going to be hard to listen to. So if you guys, you know, this Lindsay Partin case involves a little child. So it could be triggering for people. So please, if this is not your cup of tea, but this is not about, this is about the truth. This is about the truth. This is about logic. This is about so many of my viewers are moms. Could you ever be, can you ever imagine being in Lindsay's position that you were literally just, like, helping out, you know, Jason? And, well, it's fine. I mean, I'm watching my kids, too. Like, sure, she can be here and, you know, all that type of stuff. And then all of a sudden, like, boom, you know, this transpires. And, you know, where were the doctors? Where was her pediatrician? I mean, like, come on. It's just, What? I agree. And if I was Hannah's mom or Hannah's sister, I would want the truth. Because my sister or daughter deserves the truth. If you truly think that you got the truth out of that trial, then I believe that you're being naive and that And I understand that, though, because when you're grieving and when you're hurting, you'll take anything. But I don't think that Hannah would want somebody to pay the ultimate price for something that they did not do. Nobody would ever want that. But yeah. What is up? So yeah, we're going to be back here at 9. But the ultimate question that everybody should be asking is, who is Chris? And then how much does drugs play into this? I think that drugs is a lot into this case. So I'm going to talk about everything that people don't want to talk about, but if you don't talk about it, then you won't get to the truth. And I hope you guys are going to be back here with me at 9. Mod Squad, I support you too. Thank you for the hearts. So I'll see you guys back here at 9 Eastern Standard Time. So this will just restart up with a countdown beginning at 9 p.m. So thank you guys, and I look forward to chatting with you guys and probably having a couple special guests. So I'll see you guys back here at 9.